no.
Hey everybody, it's Andy Kushner, host of The Wedding Biz, and this is another episode of The Next Level, in which a guest co-host and I discuss the most recent interview of the week, and we suss out a few key topics in order to help give you some tips, ideas, tactics to bring your own business to the next level. And before I introduce today's illustrious guest co-host, I want to mention that last week's episode, if you missed it, I had interviewed live in front of the DC chapter of WIPA, which was a really fun, different way of doing it. I interviewed celebrity makeup artist Carl Rae, who is also the official makeup artist for former First Lady Michelle Obama. We spoke all about that. And he has some other recognizable clientele, including Meryl Streep, Paul McCartney, Leonardo DiCaprio, Morgan Freeman, former President Bill Clinton, and former President Barack Obama. So it was a really informative conversation. And then on Wednesday, I had Julie Sabatino of The Stylish Bride, who talked with me on The Next Level about the interview. And if you don't know Julie, she had so much great stuff to say. You really should check it out. Julie was also a previous guest on the show. So today's guest co-host is Bill Bowen, a videographer whom I interviewed on February 25th of this year, and who I believe really leads with his heart, allowing him to capture the most emotional moments of weddings and other events. He's also created some amazing, very touching legacy films. And at the end of this, we're going to give his social media handles and website so you can check him out. And again, go back to February 25th to listen to his interview. We'll also have that in the show notes. And the guest who we're speaking about, which we released a couple days ago, was Andrea Eppolito, a wedding planner and event designer out of Las Vegas, who also speaks, consults, offers a one-of-a-kind service called The Wedding Editorialist, in which she helps couples create their own wedding magazine and album. And soon she's going to release an educational site. Andrea has also started her own podcast. So Bill, you know, one of the first topics that came up really early in this conversation, which was really touching to me, she was talking about, well, first I was asking her about where she, you know, got her passion for doing parties. And she was telling me this story about when she was younger, her cousin was about to have a sweet 16 party, and her cousin's father had just died just a couple months before. And she was talking to her father, Andrea, saying, well, you know, I guess this is going to be put off. And he said, no, 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 it's not. And she said, well, how can I go? And he said, look, life is filled with really high highs and very low lows. And when we have a high worth celebrating, it's a really important cause that gets you through the hard times and gives you something exciting to look forward to and something beautiful to look back on. I thought that was really profound. And so that's when she realized, wow, I want to be a part of that world, you know? And I feel that this is something that you really resonate with from the conversation that we had, right? Is just how special, if you're really aware of what these parties are about, you know, it gives us a whole different meaning to what we're doing and motivation.
Yes, I think you're right on that. A lot of times people don't realize in the industry that these are once in a lifetime events for people. And this is like family history. They'll look back on this in 50 years and just get that warm feeling with all their friends together, and especially people that aren't with us anymore.
Yeah.
You know, they're going to be remembered.
Yeah. So also, you know, connected to that, she said, and I love this, that quote unquote, I believe that the greatest luxury of all is love. And, you know, she talked about people going through life not finding, as she said, a person, a community, or something they feel so passionate about that fuels your existence, and how so many people struggle their whole lives and don't find that place to land. And even if the whole event thing went away, she feels like she's one of the luckiest people in the world, you know? So, you know, specifically with weddings, you're getting married, it's a celebration. I love this too, Bill, that of a relationship that already exists, right? It takes you to this moment that sets the tone of how you're going to live your lives together.
I find a lot of times that they can get through the wedding process, that also helps bond people in a good way. I mean, that's a lot of stress having to deal with relatives and...
Oh, we've seen it all, haven't we?
planning the biggest day of your life, yeah. Especially for a bride who may have been thinking about this for years. Yeah. So, you know, a lot of times, one of the favorite things for me for weddings is to see the first time the bride and groom see each other and see that magical moment that they're going to remember forever. And it's great to know that I'm going to have that on tape. And they're going to look back on their anniversaries and they're going to see that. And it's just going to be wonderful.
Yeah. And, you know, part of this whole process too, she was talking about, and I'd love to hear your take on it too for yourself, is when she first gets together with clients, you know, in order to get to that point where, because it's such a vulnerable thing, like that's what you're just talking about. So for her to be as effective as possible with what she does, planning and design and us for what we do, she talks about how in the very beginning, when she first meets a client, she doesn't want to talk about the event for a while, right? She just wants to get to know them, connect with them, you know, which so many guests on the show talk about. But I love how she's saying right up front, she really wants to get to the point where she gets a feel for who they are as people, which obviously then informs her, you know, in terms of planning and design, what she's going to do. And that she's also choosing them as much as they're choosing her. I mean, that's kind of another topic. But the point is that by the time they start to talk about the event, the wedding, they feel somewhat like friends. And now they can't imagine choosing anyone else. That was a great angle on it, you know, to look at it.
I think that's fabulous. A lot of times some of my people in the office say, well, how come you talk to clients so long? And I said, it isn't about, you know, the wedding per se or the event. It's more about, you know, who they are, how they feel about things. Mm. I may ask them things that they're looking forward to as far as moments on their wedding day. Mm-hmm. And I get a good feeling for what's important for them and what's not important. And it's a really, it's a very effective thing to have small talk or talk about stuff besides, you know, what they're stressed out for being the wedding day.
Well, yeah. You know, to me, it's almost like making friends for the first time.
Exactly.
Right? It's interesting because when I was younger and new at this, I'm laughing. I would be so embarrassed if I could hear myself talking to clients. I was so much more official, you know, and I dig right in and I was so concerned about getting the sale, right? And all of that. And I find too that it was more stressful for me, right? I mean, you run it. So now I'm thinking the way I am now after all these years, not only is it more fun because all I want to do is just hang at first, basically. Just have fun with them.
Yeah.
And let it kind of flow from there.
Yeah, I think you're right. A lot of times I tell, you know, the guys in the office here, I says, and when you first have an initial conversation or with someone, a lot of times they're deciding whether they like you or not, whether they're going to be able to get along with you.
Yeah.
You know, given that your work is good, you know, they're calling you because they saw great work or they got a good referral. But a lot of times they're doing their first impression on the phone. What kind of person is he? Is he someone that I want to be able to work with and relate to and be stress-free on the whole project?
Yeah.
So a lot of that talk ahead of time, not necessarily about the wedding, is so important.
Yeah, well, and also like you and I, so you do video, I do music. We need to be in touch with them. But, you know, Andrea, as a planner and designer, she's in contact with these people for, you know, God knows how many times over a period. It could be a year and a half. I mean, geez, if they don't connect, can you imagine?
I frankly don't know how party planners or event planners can do that. I mean, I have, you know, one day with them.
Yeah.
And I might have a couple of hours of setup and talking to them. Uh-huh. But for someone who's basically going to be living with someone for a year ahead of time,
yeah,
and hearing all of their fears and things like that, and I'm sure clients bring other things besides wedding days to her.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, yeah, my mother-in-law is this and that or whatever. And she almost, I think, has to be a therapist.
Yeah, you know, it's funny you say that because even, I don't know if you've been through this, you know, and again, with everything Andrea talked about, that's so apropos. And a lot of people on the show have talked about the therapy aspect of it, right? Having to deal with it. I don't know if you had this, even myself with the music. I mean, I'm going to, same kind of thing. I want to spend some time with them and, you know, custom design this whole thing for them. I've been in situations where they will start arguing in front of me. There was one where it was, let's see, I was meeting with the bride and her mother. Like, this is for real, you know, and we're getting into the whole thing about the vibe and the feel of the party. They started really fighting in front of each other. And later, the mother called me and she said, you know, my daughter doesn't even want to speak to me right now. And, you know, again, I was kind of witness to some of this. So I got a good vibe about what's going on between them. And she said, I just don't know what to do. I'm so upset about this. And I acted like a therapist on the phone. And it wasn't even that deep what I said, but it was something she needed to hear. I said, it sounds so obvious, but she needed to hear it. I said, you know, I would recommend that you have a conversation with your daughter where you ask her just what does she really want? You know, just to kind of maybe start from scratch. And what is it? Because obviously you love her the way you're bringing this up to me. It's so obvious. And she, again, this sounds obvious to us, but I was acting the role, I guess, of a kind of a lightweight therapist. And she called me later another time to thank me to say how well that went. But I mean, seriously, right? We are in those positions. It gets so vulnerable.
Yeah. A lot of times I need to find out, since I'm recording everything, of how laid back I need to be, how right there I need to be. So a lot of times finding out the personalities of the people and what they're most worried about. I mean, a lot of times I will have either the bride or the groom. One of them wants video, one of them doesn't want video. And then I say, well, what is the groom worried about? Our groom is worried about you're going to have a big camera in his face and you're going to have a light going on. He's going to have to perform. And I said, let me talk to him. And after a few minutes talking to the groom, you know, I say that it doesn't need to be that way. It can be very much a photojournalistic type of video where you may not even know I'm there. That makes all the difference in relieving some of their fears.
You know, we're talking about, it's more than IQ, it's EQ, right? Emotional intelligence. Andrea also talked about that, having that angle on it to really understand someone as far as, you know, making the connection and figuring out what they want and need and how... You know, Bill, you and I were talking before we hit the record button about how technology is changing so much and how we communicate is different, right? There's less in person. There's even starting to be less on the phone, you were saying to me.
Yeah. You know, to give you an idea, my daughter won't talk on the phone at all. So, the right. only way she says, if you don't text me, I'm not going to call you back. Oh. And she knows that I deal with the phone.
Yeah.
And she deals with text. So I text her to say, please call me at this
right.
time.
Yeah.
And she'll text back and say, okay, I'll call you at that time. So it's a real disconnect a lot of times when young people aren't used to conversing with people. Mm-hmm. So I feel it's important to get that one-on-one feeling on the phone so you can get voice inflection. You can really feel, because a lot of times people will say something in text and you don't really know what that means. You know, is she serious about this? Do I take it literally? And, you know, the words that are used in text can be interpreted different ways. And when you have someone on the phone, you can figure out which way they're leaning by their voice.
Oh, yeah. I've had, I can't even count misunderstandings I've had between text messages and emails, especially.
Exactly.
Emails. And also, even if there's not a misunderstanding, you get into this back and forth. And sometimes I forget. I just pick up the phone. I said, let's just talk this out.
Yeah.
You know, let's talk through this.
And a lot of times you can spend 2 weeks talking to someone over text where you could gotten it done in 5 minutes on the phone.
Yeah.
And yeah. So they understand where you're coming from and you understand where they're coming from.
Well, and then add to that, when you can be face-to-face with someone. I mean, look, you know, Andrea in her position as a planner and a designer is going to be face-to-face.
Right.
But still, I've heard, it didn't come up with her, but some other planners and designers where they would like to have more face-to-face. And again, people are more, the default is to text, is to email or something like that.
Well, I mean, years ago, I used to see 90% of my clients. They'd come in with their parents, sit around the table, we'd show some videos. They would talk about what they want, what they don't want. I'd get a good feeling. But recently, I haven't had anybody in here in 6 months.
Now, sometimes 6 months.
6 months. Now, sometimes I'll send them videos, yeah. And then I'll talk to them on the phone after they've seen the video. But a lot of times, they're just, you know, the bride lives in New York, and mom is here
well,
in Washington.
Well, if they're out of town, yeah.
And or still, you know, when they come into town, they've got such limited time. So it really depends on how important your service is to the overall wedding day. Mm. I would say with a planner, she's handling everything. Mm. So you really need to have a one-on-one quite often with the client.
Yeah.
But for some of the other services, maybe less. But, you know, a lot of times if I can get 5 or 10 minutes on the phone with the bride, that's wonderful. I feel that's a bonus. And I can literally talk to somebody for 5 or 10 minutes and know exactly what they want.
Yeah. I mean, like you said, you get the inflections, all of that. You know, and before we wrap up, I want to say, too, it's interesting. Recently, I was talking to a groom who ended up being my main contact. I eventually did meet the bride, but I was talking to the groom. The first time that we talked, and it was an out-of-town, you know, one, so we got on the phone. This is, you know, I don't know that this is a technique. I enjoy doing it. It's comfortable, but I found that if I kind of assume that we're already friends, this is one thing I do. So when we got on the phone for the first time, right away, just started to bullshit. I mean, and I heard something in his voice where he was cool with it, you know, and right away, and we're laughing within literally within seconds, like probably 20 seconds. We start talking like just about anything, but by the time it came to the point to have to talk about the music and some business here, it was like we were friends. So I, you know, just to bring it back to Andrea, I love her whole take on this, and that for her, what's driving her is that story from when she grew up, that we all need to have the celebrations and we need to connect.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. I've done some, in fact, I did an event last weekend where the great grandparents had passed away 2 years ago. Well, the mother of the bride had the foresight to get some video of them talking about how they're looking forward to Andrea meeting a good man and getting married.
Yeah.
And we can't wait to see that.
That's beautiful.
And since they passed 2 years before the wedding, we actually played that at the party at the end of Dad's welcoming speech.
Oh, geez.
And Grandpa comes on the screen.
Yeah.
And he says what he says. And it was a surprise to the bride.
Wow.
She starts crying immediately.
Yeah.
And the whole room had a warm feeling. I mean, it just brought everybody together like, oh, my God.
Yeah. You know? And what a great tone to set for the rest of the night.
Exactly.
You know? Well, that is all we have time for today. You know, I want to thank everyone for listening. And Bill, thank you for joining us today.
Okay.
I want to mention Bill's website, which is suburbanvideo.com. And his social media handle is suburbanvideo. Be sure to check out his interview on The Wedding Biz February 25th of this year. And also the star of the week, Andrea Eppolito. Absolutely got to check out her website. She's got two. Her wedding website is AndreaEppolitoEvents.com. You can go to the show notes to get the spelling of all of this. Her educational website is AndreaEppolito.com. And her social media handle, Andrea Eppolito. Talk about some good branding. She was able to grab all of that. So again, thanks everyone for listening. And let me just tell you that next week's release is going to be a very exciting one. This is a new one for me on the show. Ray Thompson of Images by Lighting. I met with him in Los Angeles. We had such a dynamic, electric conversation. Ray is, in my opinion, like one of the pioneers of lighting design. It was fascinating and how he basically talks about choreographing emotion through lighting. So you all got to check that out next week. So again, this is The Next Level, and thanks for listening to The Wedding Biz.